10 common signs and symptoms of nerve damage in your body. Nerves are like cables that carry electrical signals through your body to and from your brain. Unfortunately, sometimes the little branches of these nerves may get injured or damaged, and this causes unusual sensations in your body, like tingling, burning, or numbness, or even some severe pain and inflammation if a nerve gets pinched. In this video, I'm going to be exploring the most common symptoms of nerve damage to watch out for, and I'll also be sharing some tips and remedies that you can use to help reverse and heal your nerve damage. Just a quick reminder, this video is for educational purposes only, so do speak to your doctor if you have any medical issues at all. The first symptom of nerve damage, which is extremely common, is pins and needles. If you notice a pins and needle sensation in your skin, which may also feel like a burning, a stabbing, a numbness, or a shooting pain in different parts of your body, you are likely suffering with a type of nerve damage called neuropathy, or more specifically, parasthesia. This nerve problem happens because of high blood sugars, which are damaging the little blood vessels connected to your nerves, especially in the feet, the toes, or even the hands. Another symptom of nerve damage is pain that runs down one leg. There are different large sensory nerves that run down the front, the side, and the back of the leg, and these nerves are all connected to your spine. Occasionally, a disc in the spine can bulge outward, and this can pinch or compress one of the nerves, causing a sharp shooting pain that runs through the buttock and down one leg to the thigh. Depending on which of the nerves gets pinched, the pain can be on the front, the side, or the back of the leg, and you may sometimes get numbness near your knee. In order to fix this problem, you need to speak with a physiotherapist about exercises that can take the pressure off your spine to allow the nerve to be released. Another symptom of nerve problems is vertigo. If you suffer from a bout of vertigo, it may feel as though you or your surroundings are spinning. Sometimes a small calcium crystal in your ear may cause this, which sends incorrect nerve signals to the brain, causing you to feel very dizzy. Other times, it can be caused by an infection in your inner ear, which is also affecting the vestibular branch of nerves. Both of these conditions are treatable, by the way. The next symptom is losing your sense of smell or taste, which can also be a sign of nerve problems. There are also nerves that sit behind your sinuses, and these are what they call the olfactory nerves. These are our senses, which help us to pick up different smells and aromas. If this nerve becomes damaged because of high blood sugars or perhaps a zinc deficiency, you may lose your ability to smell things properly, or you may experience phantom smells that aren't actually there. As smell is also connected to taste, this can also affect your ability to taste food normally. Sweating too much or too little may also be related to certain types of nerve damage. Now, what you need to know is that your nervous system controls how much you sweat in order to keep your body temperature stable. However, the nerves that control sweating are also very sensitive to things like stress, strong emotions, and hormones. So, an imbalance in the body can cause you to oversweat or undersweat. Benfotiamine, a form of vitamin B1, can be very helpful with this, as taking it can help to reset the balance between different parts of the nervous system. The next symptom that I'd like to talk about is heart palpitations. Autonomic nerves are involved with sending and receiving signals that control your heartbeat and maintain its regular rhythm. If you have some type of autonomic nerve problem, you may experience palpitations, where you feel a fluttering or a pounding sensation in your chest that comes and goes, and this usually happens at night. Palpitations are often caused by a magnesium or a vitamin B12 deficiency, because these are involved with nerve signaling inside the heart. Moving on now to symptom number 7 of nerve damage, which is tremors. Another common symptom of nerve damage is tremors that occur in the hands, the head, or the central part of your body. Essential tremors can be mistaken for Parkinson's disease, but are usually caused by nerve damage due to a vitamin E or a B12 deficiency. To help prevent this problem, consuming B vitamins can help, along with magnesium and caprylic acid from coconut oil. The next symptom is dribbling urine. There are also nerves involved with contracting and relaxing your bladder when you need to urinate or pee. With nerve problems, you may notice that you start dribbling urine and you're not able to squeeze and close the valve tightly when you're finished. Or you may have an urge to run to the bathroom very suddenly, without warning. People who consume lots of refined foods and sugars often suffer with this problem, because the extra glucose or sugar that's entering the blood causes nerve damage around the bladder and the urinary system. This can also be caused by a urinary tract infection, prostate enlargement, or a kidney issue. And the next on the list, which is extremely common nowadays, is wrist pain. In the modern world, we tend to use our wrists and our thumbs more frequently because we're holding cell phones, we're writing, or we're using computers. These repetitive motions put a strain on your wrist, and this causes inflammation that compresses the median nerve, and this causes nerve pain, numbness, or tingling in the fingertips. You may also notice that your grip strength may be weaker. Taking a vitamin B6 supplement can help to nourish this nerve to promote healing. And number 10 is pausing your breath during sleep. Let me explain. If a loved one tells you that you stop and start breathing intermittently when you sleep, you are very likely to have a vitamin B1 deficiency, which is causing problems with the phrenic nerve that controls your diaphragm and your breathing. You may overcome this by lowering your blood sugars, and to learn about that, see my previous video entitled 8 Ways to Lower Your Blood Sugars. You can also start consuming nutritional yeast to boost your vitamin B1 intake. How to reverse nerve damage? Now that you've become aware of some of the common symptoms, you're probably asking, well, how can I start to repair these damaged or injured nerves? Firstly, I'd recommend cutting back on refined carbohydrates, processed foods, and sugars by going low carb. Start eating more vegetables instead in the cruciferous family, such as celery, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, cauliflower, collard greens, arugula, etc. These vegetables are rich in potassium and magnesium, which can help to balance out your blood sugars and restore your nerves. Next, you may consider taking a benfotiamine supplement on a daily basis. 300 mg of benfotiamine, a fat-soluble version of vitamin B1, can be taken twice per day to help reverse nerve damage. This is very special because, being fat-soluble, it can penetrate through the fatty covering around your nerves called myelin in order to help regenerate them from within. Intermittent fasting is also an excellent tool for repairing the nerves. Since most nerve problems are caused by blood sugar fluctuations, consider intermittent fasting to help balance out your blood sugars. Eat all of your calories for the day in a strict 8-hour window, drinking only water for the remaining 6 hours of the day. This boosts the antioxidants in your body, which can both repair and protect the nerves. Omega-3s are also vital for repairing the nervous system. I recommend that you start eating seafood rich in omega-3s like wild salmon, sardines, mackerel and shellfish, or even virgin cod liver oil at least 3 times per week. These seafoods contain DHA and EPA, which improve synaptic plasticity, helping the neurons to communicate through the brain and the nervous system, whilst also helping to lower inflammation and stimulate healing. You may also want to look into physiotherapy in some circumstances. If you have a pinched nerve on your wrist, a bulging disc in the back of your spine, or some type of physical obstruction that's affecting the nerve directly, you will need to look into physiotherapy and acupressure techniques to help fix these mechanical problems that are affecting your nerves. Next, I'd also like to recommend focusing on getting your all-important B vitamins. B vitamins, in particular B1, B3, B6 and B12, are all essential when it comes to repairing nerve damage. You can get most of these in the natural form by eating unfortified nutritional yeast and having this every single day. But when it comes to B12, however, you must get this from animal sources like red meat, liver, seafood and shellfish, etc. And last but by no means least, magnesium. Take 200 milligrams of magnesium glycinate twice per day to help relax the nervous system and improve communication between the nerves. If you suffer from anxiety, overthinking or stress, this remedy in particular will be very helpful in switching off the fight or flight response in your body. This can also help to keep your blood sugar stable, which is necessary to facilitate the regeneration of your nerves. If you'd like to go a little deeper and learn more about specific nutrients to heal the nerves, you may want to watch this video that I've put on your screen now. Thank you so much for watching my video today, and as always, I wish you great health, wealth, and happiness.